Okay, student, today we will discuss concept of relationship. In previous video we were discussing concept of entity relationship model over there. In first one video we discussed concept of the different component of ER model. One is entity. Then next one we discussed concept of the attribute. Now we are having the concept of the relationship. In entity, we discuss entity type, entity instance, and entity set. Then we describe the concept of entity type. If you have any problems, then you can view the video. Title of that one video is entity relationship model and concept of entity or entity. And then type of entity, then type of attribute. I am Bilarsan from Data Science Center. Today we will discuss concept of relationship. As relationship, the meaningful association among the entity type, that is called relationship. Relationship is the associations among the instance of one or more entity type, that is called relationship. We say that relationship act like glue that hold together the various component of ER models. An example is here. We are having two different entities are available. One entity type is here student, and second one entity type is here course. So these two different entity types are there. So when we say that relationship are the glue that hold together the various component of ER models. So relationship associate, meaningful association among the entity types. So here association between entity type student and course, that is a completes. So student complete course. So completes is here used as a relationship. Right? How we can represent it? So whenever we are having the different type of entities, types are available. So relationship graphically represented by line labeled with the name of relationship. So here we are having student entity type, course entity types. We have to draw the lines over here to represent the relationship, and here we have mentioned the label line. I have complete description over here. Student, course. So here complete is the meaningful association among the entity type, and that is a line label with the name of relationships. Or another method is, if we say we are having here complete entity is available, student is entity type, attributes are here identified, that is the roll numbers, name is here the complete attribute, but it attribute of student entity. Now second one here we are having the course entity, course ID, course title, and the topic, that is a multi-value attribute. So here we are having the meaningful association among the these two entity, that is a completes. And how we can represent line labeled with the name of relationship, that is called, that is the method for the graphical representation of the relations. Now in graphical representation methods, and second method, if you see that we are having the implies available entity having the attribute roll numbers, names, date of birth. Name is a composite attribute. So for the component of this one is here first names, middle names, last names. Second entity is here course, course ID, title, and topic. Then here we say that complete, using the diamond symbol we may be able to represent the relationship. So here in this one method, diamond symbol is used to represent the name of relationship. Okay, now we are having the relationship instance. Association between the entity instance, which include one occurrence from each participating entity types. So here participating entity types are here employee and, sorry for drawing rectangles. Okay, and second entity type is here cores. So what we see, association between the entity instance. Entity instance are here chain, metals, and others are here. We are having cores. Entity instance are C++, Java, and others. So here we see association between the entity instance. Chain is enrolled with the C++. In C++, we are having the chain. In C++, we are having the Meltan. Similarly, we are having Java. With Java, we are having chain. With Java, we are having Shellco. And with Java, we are having others also. So, here we are. Whenever we are using association, each instance, we are having association between the each entity instance, which include one occurrence for each participating entity type. So here we are having the one occurrence of each participating entity type. So each line represents a relationship instance between employee, one employee and one course. One line represents the relationship between the one instance of entity type employee and one instance of entity type course. Now we are having concept of attribute and relationship. Attribute are associated with our relationship. Whenever we are having attribute on the relationships, like here we are having entity type is here employee, second entity type is here course. Name of relationship, what we see? We see that line with labeled the name of relationship is here completes. So that complete is attribute that we may not be able to associate it with the employee entity type or course entity type. So this one attribute is associated with the relationship. Whenever we are having such attributes belong to the relationship, and we may not be able to attach this one attribute to any entity type, like that complete, if we attach it over here, that imply that complete. What that complete? Like one imply complete 10 different courses. So here it's we will not be able to associate it over here. If we are having courses here, in course entity we are using that complete. So we will again, one course is completed by the different employees. One course is completed now by one employee, then next one is completed by the 5 months before, then 2 months, then 3 months, and so on. We are having the different dates are there. So we may not be able to associate this one attribute over here with this one entity type. Whenever we are having attribute that we can't associate with any of the participating entity type, what we have to do? We have to associate that one with the relationship. Each instance of the relationship complete, there is a value of that complete. Similarly, another method is if we say that one entity type is here teacher, second type is here course, teacher, teacher ID, teacher names, course ID, and titles. Now, if here we are in T times, T durations, teacher with T times, one teacher teaches many times, durations of the different subject is different. So we may not be able to associate T time and T duration with any of these ones, entity types. So we are having attribute on the relationships. So here relationships are T's, we are using it over here, the relationship, attribute on the relationship, one is here T time, T duration, teachers teach data structure at 10 a.m. for 2 hours. So, now we are in concept of associative entity. What is associative entity? An entity type that associate the instance of one or more entity type and contain attribute that are belong to the relationship between those entity type. When we say that entity type that associate the instance of one or more entity type, that we are having two different entity types are there, they associate the instance of one or more entity and contain attributes belong to the relationships. Like previously we said that here we are having entity type that are associated with the instance of different entity types and contain attributes on the relationships. Attributes belong to the relationships. That those attributes between these entity instances. So that is called associative entity. Whenever we are in concept of the associative entity, here you said it's certificates, that complete. We are previously we said it's here we let me show again. Here, that complete is the attribute on the relationships. Right? Whenever we are having attributes in the relationships, what we have to do? We are using it over here the concept of the associative entity type that associate the instance of one or more entity type and contain attribute on the relationships. So for that one, we use it over here the new entity type. And what is the difference over here? And these two entity types we are having the rectangles, but now we are having the rectangle is available but rounded corner rectangles. We have to mention any specific names, any suitable names for this one associative entity types. So here we see that that complete was the attribute on the relationships. So for that one we create the new entity types and that is called associative entity type. Now here we are not using any relationships, no relationship names mentioned over here. Why? Because associative entity type itself a relationship. Associative entity type is like a relationship with an attribute, but it is also considered to be an entity. Now when should a relationship with attribute instead be associative entity type? What are the conditions? And whenever we have to use the concept of the associative entity type. Associative entity type exists only when all participating entity type have many relationships. Whenever we arise the different entity type that are participating in a relationship and they are having many to many relationship. Whenever relationship among the different entity type, that is many to many, use associative entity type. First one condition. Associative entity type have meanings independent of other entity types. We can independently use it, the associative entity type. Associative entity type have its own identifier and other attributes. Whenever we are having the associative entity type, it has its own identifiers. Whenever we have many-to-many relationships, use the associative entity type. Whenever we are having attributes in the relationship, use associative entity type. And third one condition is also there. Whenever we are having the ternary relationship, then we have to use the associative entity type. Now another method is how we can represent it. Imply course. Here over here we are having the relationship name is here. That is in the form of diamond symbols, certificates, and what we said is here we have to use attribute on the relationships. In this way we can represent the concept of associative entity. In next video we will discuss concept of degree of relationship, unary, binary, and ternary, and then we will discuss the different type of structural constraints. Thanks for watching video. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel.